Now let's go on with what we left off the previous hour. Page 12. Now I revert to the Chinese version. 中文哈，十二页，中文最后一句。 如来常说：“汝等比丘，知我说法如法语者，法上应舍，何况非法？汝等比丘，比丘就是出家人啊，受比丘戒的，那这个俗称叫和尚了啊，就是比丘戒，要受250戒，那就叫比丘啊。譬如说，我受过比丘戒。” 就是比丘啊，出家法师啊。知我说法如法语者，你们如果知道我说法要加个锁子，我所说法就如法语。法是什么？法是皮筏啊，皮筏是什么？就是如果你要以古代要过黄河啊，那没有船，就要用皮筏或竹筏。 或是木筏啊，那个叫做筏。那筏是做什么用的？就是过渡用的啊。那法上应舍，何况非法？那法语是什么意思呢？就说佛所说的法是要让你过渡那个河，那个河是什么？河是生死河啊，生死河。所以如果渡了。 这个生死河，你坐着木筏，啊，搭了木筏，从此岸渡到彼岸，此岸表示说生死烦恼，彼岸就是菩提涅槃的彼岸，啊，这个，那渡了生死河到了彼岸，你坐的那个筏，既然到了彼岸以后，你就舍筏登岸，听得懂吗？舍筏登岸。 那，然后就上岸了，然后就去做你要做的事情了啊，因为，啊，那这个是比喻什么？比喻解脱啦，啊，解脱从生死的此岸到，解脱到不生不灭的菩提涅槃的彼岸啊，那所以你已经舍到了岸了，到达彼岸就要舍筏登岸，舍了筏登岸以后哦。 你就不必要说，哎，这个筏太好了，这个帮助我能够渡这个生死河，所以啊，我舍不得丢，所以呢，我就把那个筏就背在背上，背着跑，啊，有没有人这样子的？有没有？没有嘛，对不对？哎，你为什么还要背着那个筏呢？不过我告诉你哈，在古代的时候，你们知不知道？ 有那个 Vikings， 知不知道 ？Viking 就是那个瑞典啊、挪威啊，那个北方啊，在那个 the Vikings， 他们就海盗啊，而且很强悍啊，然后十几二十个人就划了一条舟，然后每个人都划，然后到了以后就。 抢劫、杀人啊，然后要登岸的时候，因为怕那个怕他们船被偷走了以后，他们就回不了家了，对不对？所以他们上了岸以后，就大家一起扛着那一条舟，就上去，然后先放好，然后藏好了，然后再去打，这样子就好像变成两栖作战一样了啊！这个登陆艇登上以后，还把登陆艇开上去，这样子啊。 但是这个佛法你就不要那个舍法就你登岸就舍法就登岸了嘛，啊，那么这又有一个寓言呢、啊，就是那个什么《伊索寓言》里面，《伊索寓言》不是里面有一对父子，他们这个要进城啊，就牵着他们家的一头驴，对不对？啊，那就进城的时候，因为他们是乡巴佬啊，然后就有人在路上就说。 哎，这对父子怎么那土呢？有驴还不骑呢？啊、哦，于是那个这个老子就叫小子就坐上去了，啊、哦，就牵牵牵。再牵一阵子，有人就说：“哎，这个小子怎么这么不孝呢？哎，他老子这个牵着驴，然后他坐在那么舒服。”于是呢，就叫他小子下来，然后这个老子就坐上去了。老子坐上去又再牵一阵子以后呢，然后这个又有人说：“哎，这个老子怎么这么的不慈爱呢？怎么这让那个小孩子这样子受苦呢？”啊、哦，于是呢，他们又下来，哎、又说那个老子就说：“好，你也上来。”就两个人就坐上去，两个人坐上去以后呢，又走了一阵子，那有人看到又说。哎，这两个人怎么搞的？这个虐待动物，哎，两个人骑在这上面，把那个驴给累死了。你看啊、哦，于是他们又两人就下来，于是又变成回到最前面了，就拖着驴子走。然后又有人见到说，这两个傻子嘛，有驴不骑，怎么会拖着驴走嘛？于是他们两个说，啊，怎么办呢？骑也不是，一个人骑也不是，两个人骑也不是，怎么办？干脆我们两个扛着驴子走。于是他们两个爷俩就扛着驴子进城。这个我拿来比喻说，到了岸一样以后应该舍筏登岸。那个筏你不要说那个筏太好了，我舍不得丢，就扛着那个筏走啊。所以同样，你修法修道解脱了，涅槃了，然后不要一直念念不忘，然后就执着这样子，这是指这个。啊，所以就应该要这个法也不应该贪着的意思，啊，那个不舍法背着法走，那个扛着法走，那个是指贪着那一个法，那个法也是一样，你不要认为这法太好，能够帮我度涅槃啊，到涅槃，然后所以你就贪着它，因为你贪着它，我刚刚讲过，你贪着法就反而不得解脱，就被那个法给。腐了叫法腐 ，OK， 所以你本来是解脱的，但是因为你贪着法，所以反而被佛法给腐了。可是你被世间法腐还有救，被佛法腐了那没医了，你知道吗？因为谁能够这个帮你解掉如来法的腐？这个比孙悟空的那个金刚抓栓呢还要厉害，你知道吗？哎，好。所以法上应舍，何况非法？这个法就是正法，好的法都应该要舍，都应舍。舍的意思，你注意一下，就不贪爱这样的，不是说都把它丢掉。那我告诉你哦，一个东西你如果学了以后，你可能忘掉吗？很难忘掉，对不对啊？同样，你修法修了很久以后，你成就了，虽然你不贪爱它。不执着它，但是它不会不见，也不会跑掉，因为这种到八识田心里面了，所以你放心，所以你不贪爱，并不是你不用担心说那个法就不见了，你知道吗？反而它会更牢固，反而会更这个 active， 你知道吧？能够起大的作用。你若执着的话，把它抓死了，哎，这样懂吗？啊，所以。法都应该要舍，何况非法？那不是正法的，你为什么要执着呢？所以有的人说啊，我以前这个拜了一贯道啊，或是什么、不是真正的佛法、啊，但是哈、哦，我还是舍不得。虽然我入了佛法，我还是舍不得。为什么？因为他还是对我有恩啊。我如果不是因为入了一贯道，我也不会知道佛法，让我又不会知道佛法，所以我也不会变成佛教徒。所以我现在还是常常很纪念他们，常常去跟他们参加他们聚会。你说这个对不对？那所以就是说，非法知道了就应该舍，这样的话，那法都不应该贪着了，更何况非法，你贪什么？贪着什么？所以你就感那个外道恩了、啊。然后又感外道恩，所以就减掉你感佛恩的那个善根，你懂吗 ？OK， 我们今天时间非常非常有限，所以我们要 rush， 我们不要被 rushed。 Now let's go to page 14. I would go to the last paragraph on page 14. For on the other hand, if they cease the misdharmic appearance, they are to be attached to ego, altar, multi-being, and lifespan. So either way, if you cease the right dharma, then you would be attached to ego, altar, and multi-being, and lifespan. And conversely, if you are attached to or cease the wrong dharma, then you are still attached to, or you would be attached to ego, altar, multi-being, and lifespan. So either way, you are not going to be attached to either the good or the bad. You should be free. You are always free from anything, even if they are good. But, you know, the definition of good, you need to know, it has some duration, and it is according to some circumstances. So in some circumstances, it could be good, but in other, it could not. So don't be attached to anything at all, either good or bad. So you are totally a free person. Okay, so that's what you need to do. So therefore, one should not seize the dharmas, nor should one seize the misdharma. Seize meaning grasp, own, and not to release. So you won't grasp any dharma. You won't grasp any right dharma, and nor the wrong dharmas. By this token, the Thus Adventist oftentimes divulges thus. So likewise, the Thus Adventist often divulges in this way. All ye big bhikshus should comprehend that the dharmas that I have divulged are to be likened to the metaphor of a raft. So, and it should be noted that inasmuch as the dharmas are to be abnegated, let alone the misdharmas, so I have always said that all the dharmas I teach are similar to a metaphor. Metaphor is a comparison. 隐喻啊,比喻啊,这是隐喻, of a raft. A raft, in olden times, if there are no boats to carry or convey people across a river, then they might use rafts, bamboo rafts, or leather rafts, or wood rafts. Like in the Yellow River, or in Mississippi, in the Mississippi, you used to have rafts. And what does it mean? This is a river of nascence and demise, life and death, so reincarnations. And so there are a lot of pains, sufferings, afflictions. And the reason why we want to practice Buddhism is to get across from this shore of life and death to the other shore of Nirvana and enlightenment. But how can we get across the river? We either use a ship or boat, or even the crudest, a raft. So we use a raft to get across the river. And once we have gotten across the river, then what one should do is just to relinquish the raft and get on shore. And so at that time, you would not need the raft anymore. But someone would consider that this raft is so good because it carried me through the river. So I love it so much, and I hate to lose it. So I just carry it on my back all around. So would that sound right? So it's a thing that a fool does. So the Buddha's Dharma is also the same. It helps you to get across the river of life and death. It is good. The Dharma is good. But once you have arrived at the shore, then you need to leave the raft and get on shore. So, and don't be attached to this raft anymore and carry it all around. So, and it would not do you any good, and it would encumber your actions. So, the Dharma, even if it is good, then one should not be attached to it. The Dharma, the good Dharmas, should be abnegated or forsaken, let alone the misdharmas. And the bad Dharmas should all the more be abnegated. So that one can stay totally free from anything, from any entanglements at all. So, in Zhuangzi, the great philosopher, the Taoist philosopher in China, he said, after getting at the meaning, one should forget about the words. Once the fish is caught, then one should forget about the angle. 庄子说, 得意忘言, 得于忘全. So when you got the meaning, you don't attach yourself to the words so much. So when one has got at the meaning, one should forget about the words. When one has caught the fish, one should forget about the angle. 钓竿. Okay, so much for Diamond Sutra today. Now we are going to have a special feature today, and which is a great project. I have written 23 pages, and most of it I'm going to read through. And the subject originally is the question a gentleman here asked. All religions say they are the best. How would one know which one is best? So This question is great, and it's very terrible. Because it sounds so easy and so simple, but it is a great subject. Okay, so forward. When I heard you ask this question, I had a heartfelt sympathy with you. 心有戚戚焉。 我听到你这个问题以后，我就心有戚戚焉。 Because in the past, I also had roamed in various spiritual and intellectual realms, yearning for a solid spot for the peace and repose of my unresting mind and soul. 因为在过去啊, 我曾经也在这个精神与知识的领域上浪荡, 那这个渴望求得一个安心立命之所。 I have tried deeply all the possibilities which were open to me in religions and philosophies, both Eastern and Western. 我曾深深地去深入了各种 我可能接触到的宗教跟哲学，不管是东方的或是西方的，我都深入的去追求。从我青少年的时代开始， I try not desultorily and perfunctorily, but very sincerely and diligently. 我不只是说，只是。 东摸西摸，然后浅尝辄止，而是非常的虔诚，而且非常的努力，非常的用功。I read voraciously and widely, practiced avidly, joined groups of all sorts. 我这个广设种种学士学问以及宗教。 跟他的道理 practiced heavily 而且很精进的去修行去学习而且我还参加了各种这个团体 I became a regular member of a Baptist group in my high school days for one whole year trying very hard to become a Christian. 我在高中的时代呢，就参加了一个浸信会的附中团契，这个在信义路，然后参加了一整年，而且我尝试着想要变成一个基督徒，基督教徒。 I sang hymns with them, prayed with them. I read and studied the Bible, both in Chinese and English. 我跟他们一起唱圣歌，然后跟他们一起祷告，而且我也阅读跟研究圣经，中文版跟英文版的。 And I studied the King James Version, the authoritative version. The King James Version 呢，在文学上很有地位。 I was once moved to tears by the Sermon on the Mount. 有一次呢，我还甚至于因为读新约里面耶稣的山上训词而感动的流泪。 Later, I also attended Mass in a Catholic church in Taipei. 那后来我还去参加这个新生南路的一个灵粮堂天主堂去参加望弥撒。I went to various Taoist temples to pray with my mother. 我还跟我母亲到很多的那个道教的宫去拜神，关帝庙啊，天上圣母啊， 然后这个地藏庵啊，龙山寺啊，各地我都常常跟着我妈去朝拜。I also try to become an adherent and strong supporter of a new sect of Taoist called the Heavenly Holy Mother, founded by my eldest sister, who acted as a medium or psychic. 我还甚至于尝试要变成一个新这个一个道教的一个新的宗派啊，那要变成他的信徒以及这个有力的支持者啊，这个宗派叫做这个天上圣母，那是我的大姐设立的，她是其中的基童啊。I studied Confucianism, the whole of the four books, and actually practiced it faithfully. And then I practiced on Mencius, Chan Buddhism, 老子、庄子、易经。我研习这个儒学啊，包括整个四书、大学、中庸、论语、孟子，我很多都会背，而且不只是会被了解，我看了很多的注释啊，然后而且还照着做啊。那所以我差一点就真的变成孔老二的信徒啊。然后而且我还很信心十足的去照着做，然后我又研读以及修行这个孟子。这孟子我是最喜欢的，这无善养无浩然之气啊等等，非常非常好，这个是中国真正的大伟人啊，很有正义感。中国人，中国如果有正义的话，那正义感那就是从孟子来的。好， Chan Buddhism or Zen Buddhism 啊，以及禅宗啊，然后还阅览这个。学习老子、庄子、易经，我都学会了啊！不要吃惊啊！Nietzsche、Socrates、Plato、Bertrand Russell、Franklin、胡适 and John Dewey。OK， 就是尼采、苏格拉底、柏拉图、罗素、富兰克林、胡适以及杜威啊。杜威是美国的哲学家。实证派哲学家，实证主义，我受他的害很深。我差一点就出不来，又下十八层地狱。I studied four sets of books on the history of philosophy and appreciated each philosopher and their philosophies, but was unable to determine which one is better.我曾经读了四套的这个哲学史啊，那很详细的阅读至一两次乃至一两三次都不止啊，有中文的有英文的啊，那其中有一套是罗素著的西洋哲学史啊，这么厚一本。然后这个OK, I studied the history of philosophy. 但是呢 我研读了这个四巨册的哲学史呢，而且我就很欣赏很喜欢每一个哲学家跟他的哲学，可是就没有办法决定说哪一个比较好。就是眼花缭乱，都好都好，入大观园啊。由姥姥入大观园。Now, with the help of practicing Buddha's teaching, I have gradually come to the discernment of all those great learnings with a distinct decision. 那现在，如今啊，我由于这个 得到修习如来教法之助的帮助啊，我就能够渐渐的能够得到对于这些伟大的学术能够有一个洞悉啊，洞悉了解了啊，然后而且是很清楚的有一个决断啊。Therefore, I am speaking to you not in the capacity of a religious teacher, but rather as a fellow traveler who has traversed the lands that some of you are treading, and who would present his findings to you so that it may assist you in one way or another to reach your destination as soon as possible. 所以啊，我现在啊，跟你讲话，不是以我这宗教教师的立场来说的，而是以一个 fellow traveler， 就是怎么翻译？不是同行者，同行者啊 ，fellow traveler， 同行一起旅行的啊，我们结伴一起旅行的同行者，一起结伴旅行的啊，所以用中国大陆的话就是我们是同志啊，comrade， fellow traveler is comrade。我呢，这个是当作这个同行者的同志，我已经这个走过了很多的土地国度，那而那一些土地呢，或许有一些人，你们中的有一些人正在跋涉，啊，那。我呢就呈现我的一些发现给你啊，以期就期待啊他能够帮助你这 one way or another 啊，让你能够达到啊你要去的保所啊尽早的实现。This question seems to sound so simple, but in fact, it is highly complicated and difficult. 这个问题啊，就是所有的宗教都说他们是最棒的，那到底哪一个是最棒的？我们怎么知道呢？啊，你看看，这个问题很可怕，你知道吗？ It is terribly good. 所以啊这个问题看听起来是很简单，但事实上它是非常的这个复杂跟困难。 In addition to my knowledge, a good many people do share the same doubt, including Buddhist clergy and lay people, and it would pose as a significant hindrance for one's unreserved total integrationwith active practice in full swing. 而且呢依我所知啊，有很多人也都有这同样的问题啊，同样的疑问。所有的宗教都很好嘛，都是教人为善嘛，但是哪，而且他们都是说是最好的，那哪一个是最好？怎么知道呢？好，所以很多人都有这样同样的问题，甚至于包括这个佛教的僧俗二众啊，也都有，出家在家也都会有这种问题啊。我就曾经有听过啊，甚至于就是这个佛法跟其他外道的法搅和不清的那个，都是没有办法决定说佛法是最好的原因。所以那个也就是说所谓的净信啊，这清净的信心还没有升起来啊。而且呢， 因为有这样子的疑问呢，所以啊，他就很可能变成一个重大的障难啊，能够影响我们一个毫无保留的全盘的这个跟佛法合而为一，而且这个主动积极的全面的去修行的障碍。Therefore, I think it imperative and quite rewarding if we could cope with it now and get it clarified sooner, whereby we could really get underway with the practice. 所以呢，我想就这个事情是非常紧急，而且非常也应该是非常有帮助、有报偿的啊。假如我们现在就去对付它啊，去面对它，而且把它厘清，就越早厘清越好。所以呢，我们就能够早一点在修行上上路。好 ，see the chart. In the meantime, this question obviously belongs to the sphere of comparative religion. And as such, I must perforce endeavor to tackle if we are really going to deal with it at all. So here we go. 同时呢，这个问题啊，很明显的是属于比较宗教的领域啊，因为所有的宗教都说他们最好，那就要比较各种宗教嘛，对，所以 you need to compare, make comparison。所以呢，我就必须要努力去对付这个问题啊。如果我们想要真正的去处理这个问题的话，那就必须要就做一些比较的工作啊，所以我们现在就开始啊。这个 chart 是 general comparison between Buddhism and other religions, 所以 other religions and Buddhism. First, other religions are all deism.就是有神论啊，神教啊 ，deism。那这个有神教呢，是 it is either monotheism 一神论 ，or multi-deism 多神论，不是一神论就是多神论啊。然后那不管一神论还是多神论，都是这样子的，都是 worshipping a god or gods。For His grace, 都是崇拜上帝，求其恩典，这样的。那么比较，相对于其他宗教 ，Buddhism， 第一个 ，neither deism 不是有神论 ，nor atheism 也不是无神论，因为佛也承认有神，但是只是我们不拜他，不崇拜他。因为我们于这个神鬼鬼神呢、啊、无所求，我们求的是佛道，所以不拜鬼神，是吧 ？Nor anti-theism， 也不是反神论，反对神，不是。我们以佛教徒，我们不跟任何神或是人作对。As Buddhists, we don't run contrast.Or averse to either gods or men, so we can be free. You know, we don't want to be entangled in all those struggles and arguments. That's a waste of time and life. So Buddhists practicing Buddha's holy teaching for enlightenment.这个佛教徒呢，是修学如来圣教，以求开悟，所以是不是求佛，而是学佛法求开悟，所以不是求佛，不是 光是这么磕头拜，这样你就能够开悟，能够得智慧，能够得福报，不是。你要修，就依法而修，啊 ，OK， second origin， 这一切宗教的本源缘起 ，start with the mythology or myth or folklore， 这所有的宗教啊，都是从一个神话或是一个 myth。是比这个神话更加刺激一点，但是比较接近人间，比较有实际性一点点，有点像传说一样，像 legend 这样啊，那或是 folklore 啊，或是这民间故事叫 folklore 这样的。所有的这个神教都是它的起源都是那个东西啊，但是。Buddhism starts with facts of Buddha's birth as a prince in a principality in India. 而佛法不是从神话开始，是从事实开始。这什么事实呢？是佛诞生在印度的一个小王国为太子，这样开始，都是事实，没有神话。所以都是实实际际的，哎。Third, all of them are ego-oriented, both gods and men, the followers alike. 这个其他的宗教呢，都是自我取向，啊，自我取向，就以自我为依归这样子，啊，为追求的目的。不管是他们的神或是人都一样啊，乃至于信徒也是一样，以自我取向啊。那 Buddhism contrarily is egoless and selflessness as basis， 就是以无我无私为基，如果要再讲，就慈悲为怀，智慧度一切，啊。所以为什么能够慈悲？因为无我，有我的话，那要先首先利益自己，不会要利益众生，对不对？那恕我说一句不客气，如果我为了自己的话，我就。也不用那么辛苦，我为了写这个讲稿好多个晚上没睡觉，好，但是 我这么辛苦我赚多少钱呢、啊这讲得很不好听，对，可是这事实啊，对，所以没不以任何这个利益各种利益为出发点啊。 Number four，All gods and their followers are given to anger, hatred, wrath, jealousy, and vengeance. 这一切的宗教的神啊，其他宗教的神啊，以及他的信者啊，都是放逸于嗔恚、愤恨、嫉妒与报复。当然，你要能够讲出这个必须要对他的，这是所有的宗教都要有一点点研究啊，不能口说无凭啊，要不然马上就被打死了。As opposed to that, Buddha is free from the impurities of anger, hatred, jealousy, and vengeance, totally purified.这个佛如来呢，是这个完完全全没有这个已经离开一切的嗔恚、憎恨、嫉妒、报复种种的不净。所以你看， 差多远。所以你看，我们的佛真的就是圣人了，他们的神真的还是凡夫，就所有的其他宗教都还是凡夫，因为他还嗔怒，还贪爱，还嫉妒，还报仇，你知道吗？还杀害，这样懂吗？好，然后 five, hence, fights even between gods, killing, slaughter, annihilation, holocaust, Zeus or Jupiter does it, Jehovah does it, and all other gods and men commit killing as well. 所以啊，这个因此，甚至于神与神之间都征战、杀戮、灭绝啊。这个宙斯啊，就是希腊的主神呢 啊，跟耶和华也都做这个事情。那其他人亦然啊。那你看。基督徒杀基督徒，基督徒杀回教徒，回教徒杀基督徒，他们都信同一个神呢。然后那个这个犹太教人杀回教徒，回教徒杀犹太族等等，就不管什么徒，到后来就一塌糊涂啊。Five here, thorough non-violence, no killing of any kind. Buddhists.Don't kill Buddhists. Buddhists don't kill non-believers. 所以这个完全非暴力，这个佛法完全非暴力，绝无杀戮。佛教徒不杀佛教徒，从来不杀。对，你不要不说不杀，这个在家弟子在我这边受五戒，如果杀了一只苍蝇还要跑来忏悔。对，那所以佛说一切有命的都不顾杀，以及乃至于捐非软动都不顾杀，故意杀他。为什么？不是要去你那个杀行，而是要去你那个杀心。所以这个杀心是嗔心，那为什么去杀心？其实就是要去你的嗔心，所以借着去杀而去嗔心。那嗔心的最顶端、最高的表现就是杀，那其次就是打，其次就是骂，这样。所以你若心里面起嗔心的时候，先骂，恶口骂，大声骂，破口大骂，然后接着呢就出手打，接着拿棒打，接着呢。就拿枪杀、刀杀，所以杀是嗔恨心的最高极致的表现。所以佛制不准杀，是为了要去你的嗔心。The reason why the Buddha decrees no killing is not just for you to be free from.The bad karma of killing, but because killing stems from hatred or very great anger. So the Buddha sees that anger or fury or wrath is a poison to your mind. So you don't want to, generate poison in your own mind and poison yourself. So, if you have the poison of anger in your mind, then your mind will be in disturbance, will be turbulent. So, you cannot rest, you cannot repose. So,Even if you read the sutra or make meditation, it's no good. Because there is a killing mind within there. So in order to really, get free from everything, from every impurity. So the first impurity is killing. is hatred, is the element of hatred in your mind. But only to talk about getting hatred out of your mind is no good. You need to practice it by no killing. It is the concrete deed you need to do. Otherwise, you say, oh, I'm practicing no anger, but you keep killing. Then it's a lie, you know. So, you need to follow the decree of the Buddha, which is the highest wisdom that would incorporate the internal and the external. So you need to put into practice what you really think and what is really good in your mind and in your deed too. So Buddhism is the only thing that is consistent within and without. Okay, not to say one thing or preach one thing and doing another. Okay, 所以不是说是一件事，然后做是另外一事，教人是一回事，然后自己做又是另外一回事。那其他的神都是叫人不要杀，但是自己拼命的杀。 那么佛为什么佛弟子不敢杀？因为我们的佛如来不杀，他自己就不杀，啊，这样懂吗？哎，所以你必须要自己做，身教难呐，言教容易，你知道吧？言教嘴巴两个嘴皮这样动动就行了，对不对？好，The origin of religions, as for the origin of religions, from the study of primordial history and archaeoanthropology, we have come to recognize that the power of nature and the primeval people's awe-inspired reaction to it became the origin of religions. 至于这个宗教的起源啊, 从这个上古史以及考古人类学的研究，我们就知道了这个大自然的威力啊，以及初民原始人类啊对于自然的肃然敬畏的反应。 就变成是宗教的起源，所以宗教起源是什么？就大自然的威力，以及人民害怕，所以变成宗教，这是考古人类学跟上古史的研究的结果。 When the primitive man faced nature with its immense power, unfathomable, unpredictable, incomprehensible, and invincible, they were terrified, horror-stricken, cowed to utter subjection with unspeakable fear and dismay. 当初民最初的人民，他面对大自然的时候，因为这个大自然有具有巨大的威力。 这个威力呢，是深无底洞啊，这个不可知、不可预测、不可理解，而不可克服、不可抗拒，所以呢，他们呢就非常的恐惧，而且就被降服了，乃至到了就充满了这个不可言喻的。 恐惧以及恐慌。 Thereupon, they assumed that there must be some god or deity that was endowed with and wielding these tremendous powers. 所以呢，他们就假设啊，这一定哦是有一个什么神子啊，神奇啊，啊、哦、 有什么神在那里，他具有这个这些无上的威力以及巨大的 power 啊，他们在使用这些威力。 And so in their profound apprehension they try to propitiate the presumed god or gods by worshipping, glorifying and praying to him in the hope that he would not get angry with them and even to deign his blessings to them. 因此呢，他们在恐惧中啊，在巨大的恐惧中啊，他们就想要邀宠于这些假设的神啊，崇拜他，赞美他，以及祈求于他，希望他不再对他们生气，乃至于可以赐福给他们。Incidentally, what would be the most awe-inspiring power of nature? 同时呢，什么是大自然里面最令人可敬畏的威力呢？ Beyond any doubt, Thunderbolt, with its tremendous, atrocious power in destruction, swift, unpredictable, and arbitrary in attribute, would be nominated first. 那么，无可置疑的，这个雷电，以它这个巨大而且极其恐怖伤害的威力，它迅疾不可预期，以及它不受管束的这个性质呢，可以说是居于第一位。所以大自然的威力里面，就是雷电威力最大。This is presumably the reason why both the Greek father God Zeus and the Jewish God Jehovah are the wielders of thunderbolts by which they conquer their major antagonists. 这就是为什么，我们可以假设说，为什么这个希腊宗教的主神宙斯或是 Jupiter 啊，以及犹太教的神耶和华，他们都是施长雷电的啊，因为雷电的威力最大，在大自然里面啊，那他们借着用雷电呢，就降服了他们主要的这个敌人，这是依照他们的这个故事所说的啊。比如说Zeus 降服了 Cronus 啊，然后耶和华降服了撒旦啊，都是用雷电啊。撒旦是他们的天使长。So is their predominant feature as gods, the administrant of fear, destruction, and with the turn of transition, punishment and justice. 所以啊，这就是他们身为神子的这个主要的这个点啊，主要的特征是什么呢？他们是这个可以施予恐惧破坏，所以他们施恐惧跟我们观世音正好相反，是施无畏啊。然后再有一个一转啊，就由于恐惧破坏就转成这个处罚跟公义啊。So I hope that the picture is becoming clearer now. That is why no matter how Christian doctrines may have changed through ages in all the denominations, but this main doctrine has remained intact. It got to be, for it is the backbone of Christianity.including Judaism, Islamism, That is God's wrath, God's justice, judgment, and punishment. 所以我想这个情况啊，这个 picture 就应该比较明朗一点了啊。这就是为什么不管这个基督教的这个教义啊怎么变，在整所有的时代里面它怎么改变啊，然后各个教派怎么改变，但是这个主要的教义啊，意思三民主义的义啊，这个都完全没有动，不会变的啊，就它必须要这样子。为什么？因为那个是基督教的脊柱、脊椎啊啊，包括犹太教跟回教都是这样子。那这个基督教的脊柱是什么呢？这个教义是不会变的，就是上帝的愤怒、上帝的公义。公义就是代表审判了。那审判以后通常都是处罚，没有赏赐的啦。然后judgment 审判以及处罚。Hence, it is small wonder that heretofore the cardinal virtue of a good Christian would be his fear of God with unquestioning faith. What question could one put to thunder and lightning after all? 所以啊，这一点都不惊奇啊，到现在为止啊，这个一个好的基督徒他最重要的基德基本的德性啊，这是这个亚里士多德提出来有四基德， There are four cardinal virtues proposed by Aristotle. Okay, there are four of them. 但是一个基督徒的这个主要的德性是什么呢？就是 fear of God， 就是怕神啊，畏惧神啊，而且要这个具有不可质疑的信心啊，不可质疑就是你不能问问题了啊。那但是对于这个雷电，你能问什么问题呢？所以只能够 total obedience 啊，完全的服从啊，这完全的服从也都是自己想的啦啊。So from time to time, you can hear people pronounce very proudly, "We are a God-fearing people." By which they mean, I gather, that they are not unruly, for they abide by the law of God faithfully, meekly, and unquestioningly. 所以啊，我们常常就可以听到有人就这个公然的讲，而且很 proud 哈，很这个引以为傲的哈，说我们是一个怕神的民众啊。当然我们中国也有类似的啦，说这个人啊不怕神不怕鬼，那表示这个人无法无天，对。那这个意思就是说哈，他的意思就是说，因为我们怕神啊，所以神会处罚人嘛，就好像父亲一样，父亲都是会打人家屁股的，对不对啊？那所以啊，这个我们不是 unruly， 就是不是乱七八糟啊，不遵法的啊，而我们都是呢遵从上帝的法律，很虔诚的，而且很温驯的，没有毫无疑问的啊。Therefore, so far, I think we can come to a better understanding of a Christian mind with sincere sympathy. 因此呢，我想我们可以对于基督徒啊，就会有比较好的理解，而且 有真正这个以诚挚的同情的心。However, we would also truly generate a true sympathy and compassion for Christian people or Muslims or Judaists when we juxtapose them with Buddhists. For the former are mainly motivated by fear and punishment, whereas Buddhists, to the contrary, are initiated by freedom from fear, hope, and encouragement.And painstaking instructions for wisdom, self-consciousness, and enlightenment. 这个，所以啊，我想，我们因为比较了解且同情嘛，所以我们也可以升起一个，真正的，同情以及这个慈悲，对于基督徒乃至于回教徒或是犹太。教徒啊，如果尤其是我，当我们把他们跟佛教徒并在一起看的时候，因为前者呢，他们主要的发心是由于恐惧跟处罚，而佛教徒呢，相反的呢，是他们的发心是由于无有恐惧，而。怀有希望以及受到鼓励，还有耐心而无微不至的教授啊，以求智慧跟自觉以及这个开悟。 OK, I think I won't be able to finish this today, but let meTake up your 10 minutes of your time to go through this, okay? This part, I mean. 这个放过去了。A survey. A survey and comparison of some important religions, semi-religions, and philosophies in the world. The对一些这个世界宗教与半宗教或是次宗教啊，这个以及哲学的比较啊，第一个是宗教方面啊，先讲creation 创造天地或是造物主啊 ，creation or creator of the universe。All the gods of all races in the world claim that they are the creator of the universe. Egyptian, Chinese, Hindu, Maya, Japanese, American, Indian, all the same. They claim thus. But who would be elected as a qualified and fair arbitrator to adjudge and pronounce which god is really the creator?所有的种族在这世界上所有的种族都说他们的神啊是这个是这个宇宙的创造者的造物主埃及神啊，中国神啊，印度神啊，玛雅神啊，日本神啊，乃至于美国印第安人的神啊，那印第安人就有很多的族，每一个族都有个神，他那每一个都是创造天地的。好，所以我们谁能够被选举为这个有资格而且公平的仲裁者来审断跟宣言说哪一尊神是真正的造物主？首先 ，Greek, the Greek gods are not said to be the creator of universe。接下来讲希腊神话了。Now we all say Greek mythology, but before Christianity take over, it was actually the religion of the Greek people. They believed it, and practiced its rituals faithfully, as we can see in Homer's Iliad and Ulysses and all other ancient literary and philosophical works.
我们现在都说希腊神话，但是希腊神话本来不是神话，这是希腊宗教，是希腊人所信的宗教。到后来就是因为这个基督教 take over 了啊，所以呢他就被贬为变成神话啊。那因为这个神话呢，事实上他们都是信的，是他们的宗教，而且他们都照他们的仪式来行的。你可以看那个荷马史诗里面的这伊利亚德跟这个 Ulysses 啊，或是奥迪赛 Odyssey 啊，以及其他的古代的文学历史还有这个哲学的作品啊，都很详细讲他们的宗教，而且他们都是很诚心的啊，只是他们的神运气不好啊，被那个君士斯坦丁给割掉了啊。好， Greek gods are not said to be the creator of universe. This is surprising. It is just the other way about. The universe created gods. In the beginning, there was only chaos, who later gave birth to night and Erebus, which is darkness. Then they gave birth to love, and who then gave birth to light and day, then earth, and then earth was born, parents unknown, followed by the creation of heaven, parents also unknown. It just happened. Then Father Heaven and Mother Earth gave birth to first gods, the Titans, and Aeolus, elder gods, with Cronus in Latin Saturn, as the ruler over all the universe. 所以这个希腊的神他们并没有说神创造天地，而是相反呢，这个宇宙呢创造了神啊。然后这开始的时候是一片的混沌 chaos 混乱了啊。然后后来这混沌呢就生了这个夜以及黑暗，然后夜跟黑暗就生了爱，这爱是一个神啊，然后但是爱不是维纳斯啊，这个是很远古很远古，比维纳斯还更早的神啊，然后这个爱呢就生了光跟日啊，跟日，然后接着呢这个地球啊就出生了，那他的父母是谁不知道啊，然后接着这个天就出生了，那他的父母是谁也不知道啊，就只是这么发生了啊。然后呢这个天父跟地母啊就合在一起，就生了最早的神啊，那最早的神叫 Titans， the Titanic， 有没有就从这个字来， Titan 是 very big huge 啊。那 Elder Gods 这是最早的神，那 Cronus 在拉丁文就是 Saturn， 那他是整个宇宙的统治者啊。 Later his son Zeus, Jupiter in Latin, revolted against his despotic rule, and with the help of Prometheus and other gods,He defeated Cronus, and after unmanning him, that is, castrating him, then dethroned him and became the new ruler of the whole universe. 接着呢，宙斯，这个是大家知道的，对哈，宙斯也就是 Jupiter， 他是这个 Cronus 这个老神的。老神在在啊，这老神的儿子啊，他就起来造反。为什么造反呢？因为他反对他的这个专制统治啊，所以就革命了。那 and 然后呢，这个宙斯啊，由于有普罗米修斯的帮忙呢，就把 Cronus 打败了，他把他父亲打败了，然后把他给淹了，这个小子把老子给淹了，啊，所以，那所以这个什么，这个是神话，其实是鬼话连篇，对不对？然后就把它推翻了，然后变成新的这个宇宙的主人，啊，所以啊，宙斯他有什么特点呢？第一个，乱伦，为什么？好了没有？在哪里？啊，乱伦啊。Zeus has some features. First, one is incest perpetrator. He married his own sister Hera or Juno in Latin. 因为他跟他老妹结婚啊，他老妹叫做 Hera 或是称为朱诺 Juno 啊，妹妹啦啊，然后亲妹妹。第二个。Second, he is a serial rapist. He raped Io, in the mythology of Io and Heifer, and he raped Europa, and he also raped Leda, manifest himself as a swan. 所以啊，他曾强奸了 Io, 强奸了Europa 强奸的 Leda 啊，那所以 is he sacred, romantic, more likely downright revolting. Therefore, the Buddha said, "Multi beings are so perverted as to take vile things as desirable." 所以啊，他是神圣的吗？还是很浪漫？不过比较可能的是说，他实在是很恶心。嗯，然后所以啊，佛说众生颠倒，以丑恶为美啊。Hence they would take incest, endogamy, adultery, killing, stealing, fornication.Prevarication as the favorite themes of literature, which is deemed an object of art and beauty, and even truth. As John Keats put it in his ode to an Grecian urn, beauty is truth, truth beauty. 所以啊，佛说这个众生颠倒啊，因此呢，他们甚至于还把这个乱伦、近亲通婚、通奸、杀盗淫妄等等这些事情啊，当作文学的主题啊，而且认为那是一件很美的事情，很美的艺术，不但是美啊，甚至于是真实的，是真理。所以啊，济慈这个英国十九世纪的浪漫诗人就这么说：美就是真，真即美。所以颠倒啊。Lots of Greek gods have the same problem about sex, which seems to constitute the main motif.And form the great bulk of Greek mythology, as quite vividly recounted in Ovid's Metamorphoses, which, especially in the wake of Renaissance, has come to be hailed as romantic and beautiful. 很多的希腊神啊都有对于性啊都有同样的问题，而这个性的这个问题啊，这个情节啊，尤其是强奸啊，那就变成了构成了 这个希腊神话的一个主题跟主要的部分啊。那这部分呢就在那奥卫德的变形记，奥卫德的变形记这一部是很有名的书，讲这个希腊神话里面这个男男女女怎么样沟通啊，沟通你懂我意思啊，这样的，乃至于男的怎么样强暴女的，男神怎么样强暴世间的真女，就是啊，就是处女啊，啊，神怎么样强暴处女啊，乃至强暴这个也是其他的神啊等等，这些情节啊描写的非常的生动，就成了他的这个绝世的伪构变形记，因为那些神要强暴人的时候都变形啊，就是化身为什么东西，然后去勾引处女，然后把她强暴，然后还生孩子，尤其特别是在文艺复兴以后啊，这一个主题啊就变被这个赞叹为是很浪漫而且美丽啊，美。It may be that it was taken as a trend of reaction to the Middle Age Christian or Judaic gloominess and austerity, and thereby was deemed an expression of liberation. 也很可能啊，这是在中世纪的人啊啊。中世纪的基督教以及这个犹太教的这种灰暗以及严苛的这种教旨啊，然后所以就令那个中世纪的人这个引起一种反弹啊，引起一种反弹，然后所以就研究了阅读了这个希腊神话以后，就当作一种一种解放的这种表现，这样啊。Thus we have the irony of history that Hellenism counteracts and vindicates itself over Judaism 啊，所以啊，我们就有个历史的反讽啊，就是希腊文化就反击。以及报复了这个犹太文化，因为犹太文化就是基督教，基督教取代了这个希腊的多神教啊。那现在经过1000年以后呢，文艺复兴的时候，然后人们在研究希腊文化，因为在整个中古时期，也就所谓黑暗时代的时候，这个所有的人都不准研究希腊的东西，因为那个是 pagan。因为那是野蛮的，被认为是野蛮的，没有文化的，所以不可以去研究那些，尤其是违反神的教旨啊。所以呢，希腊文化就一直被埋藏了1000年，然后到文艺复兴，大家再去研究，所以称为文艺复兴嘛啊，因为被埋藏了，所以被再挖出来啊。从 Florence 翡冷翠研究，然后开始啊，14世纪的时候，因此呢。本来被犹太文化打败的希腊文化，现在就开始报仇了，复苏了，这样的啊。然后这个文艺复兴的人呢，就当作好像表现对于基督教的一种解放啊，虽然不能真正的解放，但是写一写、谈一谈也很爽嘛，对。好 ，However, Greek gods.Prevalent licentious deeds may have been a projection and compensation mechanism or catharsis, as Aristotle phrases it in his Poetics. For the primeval mortal Greeks' own hidden, unrealized libidinal yearnings, as would be analyzed by the Freudian Greek, creeds. 这个，但是啊，这个希腊神的这种很普遍的淫荡的这个行为啊，很可能是一种投射，或者一种投射，或一种补偿机制、补偿作用啊，或者一种宣泄作用，在哪里？有没有宣泄作用 ？catharsis 啊，宣泄作用或是抒发啊，这是亚里士多德诗学里面 poetics 里面所讲的 catharsis， 就是一切文学的作用，或是诗啊，或是戏剧，就是一种 catharsis 抒发的作用，疏解的啊。我们台湾话不是说很郁卒吗？那郁闷吗？这司马迁也讲到郁闷啊。那这个日本的诗人这个橱窗白春也说，文学是苦闷的象征，对不对？所以因为你心有郁积有苦闷，所以你要发泄出来，要不然会怎么样？要不然会发疯，要不然就变成躁郁症了嘛，对。所以为了要得到心理健康，所以你一定要讲出来。那你如果找不到人讲，你就要写出来。那如果你如果不讲也不写的话，那怎么办呢？那只好去跑步了，就抒发这样的啊，所以把你心中的郁闷给抒发出来，所以这个是有道理，不过有一半的道理，因为有些东西越抒发是越多，你抒发不完，你知道吗？这不是就近解决的办法，对，因为你看了文学又感叹，感叹感叹又感叹，感叹个没完嘛，没有解决嘛，是不是？啊，可是，因为就这个就变成就是说，在古代的这个希腊人，他们自己暗藏的无法实现的这个潜在渴望，利比多啊，就是弗洛伊德心理学里面所说的这一个潜在的性冲动叫 libido 啊，那它的形容词叫libidinal 啊 ，libidinal 再来 ，libidinal yearning 潜在的性冲动。性的渴望，这样。这个弗洛伊德是一个很伟大的人，他发现了潜意识，不过他后来走入偏锋，把一切都解释做性，这样，所以那个就很麻烦，这以后再讲啊。啊，所以依弗洛伊德的信条来讲啊，就是说，这些希腊神的这些淫荡啊，可能不是希腊神的淫荡，而是希腊人他心中有了这样的欲望，但这个欲望呢又不能够真正去做，所以就造了很多的神来表演这一些事情，然后把借着这一些故事呢，把自己心中的这压抑的这个欲望给疏解掉啊，所以是神造人还是人造神呢、啊？那么，这个以希腊人来讲，我用那个弗洛伊德来解释，就很明白嘛，对不对？很明显的、啊。好，third cruelty and holocaustic genocide， 这个，later mortals became corrupted. Zeus tried to annihilate them all by deluge.Sound familiar? The ancient Jews have also the same legend related in the Old Testament. 这个希腊的主神啊 ，Zeus 啊，他是很残忍，而且大屠杀啊，那想要杀尽全人类，因为这个故事里面讲说，后来啊，这个人类啊就变成堕落了，然后这个主神宙斯啊。就要把他们全部都毁灭，那用一个大洪水把他们毁灭 ，deluge， 大洪水啊。那所以而这个在古代的这个犹太人呢，他们也有同样的故事，这个在这个旧约里面，新啊圣经旧约里面，这个 上帝呢大怒啊，因为人堕落啦，那不拜唯一的真神啊，拜很多其他的神啊，所以呢他就下雨，下大雨啊，这个七日七夜，然后把整个世界都淹没了，要把他们都淹死。The flood inundated all the world. Only the peak of Parnassus, the mountain of Poets, was not covered, whereby the two survivors, Deucalion and Pyrrha, Prometheus' son and niece, was saved in a chest, from which they landed the mountain top.The prototype of Noah's Ark, perhaps. So there are lots of parallel in the two great myths.
后来啊，这人类堕落啊，宙斯想要用大洪水把他们全部都给灭尽了啊。那么。这个大洪水啊，就淹没了全世界，只有那个 Parnassus 这个狮人山呐、没有的那个山顶没有被淹，那而且只有两个人啊，这个逃生了，他们是那个普罗米修斯的儿子跟 niece 就是子女啊，那他们是被一个 chest。一个衣柜大衣柜躲在里面，然后他们就飘到那个圣山啊，然后就获救了，所以这个跟这个诺亚方舟很像嘛，是吧？所以这个是不是那个诺亚方舟的原型，还是反过来啊？anyway， 这个希腊的神话跟这个犹太教里面圣经里面所讲的故事呢，很多都雷同的。 OK， It is very interesting. Chinese mythology. In the beginning there was one great chaos without any openings. 盘古 a giant deity ruptured the heaven and healed the earth. The Chinese mythology 就一开始的时候呢，就一片混沌，那没有一个破洞，所以啊，这个盘古是古代的一个大神啊，就拿一个巨斧啊，就开天辟地啊。Lady Wall mended the incongruous crack rigged in the heaven by her sewing with a giant needle and thread, of course. We believe, okay, 所以呢。女娲呢，因为这个盘古啊，这开天的时候把天那个洞开得太大了，太大了不行啊，而且乱七八糟的，所以女娲就去补天啊。女娲补天当然是用一根很长很大的针跟很粗的线嘛，对。然后 We believe and enjoy all these very much, but we never take it seriously. Not so much as to fight over it.For the Chinese are so incurably practical that even when they are romantic,
我们相信而且很喜欢这些故事，对。但是啊，我们从来没有把它认真，对啊。那至少不会说认真到为了这个事而打架战争，对。为什么呢？因为中国人呢、是。可救药的实际啊，所以即使他们很罗曼蒂克的时候也还是不忘实际，所以你相信有这个盘古开天辟地女娲补天，我们大概说有是不是真的有没关系，我就是有就好了，也不用去考据。好，
Second 易经And 老子 Taoist, 道家 In the beginning, there was a vast chaos, similar to Greek.
天地初始一片混沌啊。然后这个是老子的道德经里面讲的啊， Chaos begot infinitude， 这混沌生无极。然后易经里面也这样讲啊， Infinitude begot 太极 or grand ultimacy， 然后混沌生无极，无极生太极，太极生两仪，两仪生四象，四象生八卦，然后因为八卦一出现，然后就一切万物就蓬勃而生，这样的。So infinitude begot 太极 and then 太极 begot dual essences， 两仪 dual essences meaning yin yang the masculinity and femininity and then the dual essences yin yang begot quadruple appearances， 就两仪生四象，两仪就是阴阳，阴阳就生出四象，四象是什么？四象就是金木水火啊，金木水火是四象，再加一个土就变成五行了。然后两仪生四象，四象就生八卦， and then all beings came into existence including animated beings and inanimated beings 啊，所以有情无情就开始了。 The above is an epitome of Chinese metaphysics which is commonly shared by all schools of learning in China。 以上啊是中国形上学的一个缩影啊，的一个简述啊。而这个形上学呢，刚上面所说的这个混沌生无极，无极生太极等等等，一直到两仪四象八卦这些啊，这个形上学啊是所有中国的学术都共有共通的，而且共同崇奉的啊，不管是道家还是儒家，乃至于道家跟儒家是主体，那其他的这个九流十家全都是一样，都遵从这个东西的啊，认为这是无上的啊。像因为什么？从易经来的，对啊。然后 ，hence Chinese metaphysics is predominantly materialism, which signifies that material is the origin of everything, and that the essence of moving force.First cause of all things is material。 这个是我发现的，从来没有写过，因为古代的人没有什么唯物论啊，直到那个马克思出现啊才有这个唯物论啊。那所以我们尤其是台湾的人一提到唯物论呢，就悚然心动，就很恐怖的样子，可是不知道我们中国老祖宗就是唯物论者，你知道吧？中国文化的本源很惊奇吧，是唯物论。中国的这个哲学是以唯物论为首，为什么？混沌生太极，混沌是什么？混沌是物质嘛，这样的吗？然后混沌生太极，所以那太极呢生混沌生无极，无极也是一个空间嘛，那所以那个也是唯物的。然后这个无极生太极啊，然后太极生两仪，两仪就阴阳，阴阳是什么？阴阳也是物质啊。所以中国哲学或是文化的本源是唯物论，这共产主义者听了会很高兴，其他的人听了会很惊讶，可是你看这个分析啊，就是这样子啊，我也很惊讶，所以这个那什么是唯物论呢？唯物论就是说，一切一切物质、一切东西、万物的本源本质啊，是物质。那跟唯物论相反的就是唯心论，唯心论是说 一切物的这个本源啊是心，这样。但是佛法是唯心论还唯物论，都是也都不是。本质本体是心，现象界是物，这样。那这法不能只有心没有物啊，那所以是两个互相叫 interreact 产生的，这是佛法这伟大的厉害地方。Apart from scholastic metaphysics, the common Chinese believe in the folklore of heaven, who is personified but non-formed in both the creator and justice dealer of everything terrestrial, called heavenly justice. 除了这个学术上的形上学以外，一般的老百姓啊 所相信的就是天，对，这个是等于是人民间流传的这种信仰啊。那这个天啊虽然是无形无相，但是被人格化了，所以他也跟耶和华一样会生气会处罚人的，所以要骂人说你天不怕地不怕，讲的，对，因为天会处罚人的，哎，人说你这个人无法无天，对，本来是说无法就好了，可是还要加个天，因为天比较大嘛，哎，你说你这个人无法，没什么力量，你无法无天那就好了，哦，太好了，哎，啊，所以啊，这个天道啊就掌管了天下赏善罚恶的公道，也就是天道。所以呢，古代的马贼呀、啊，或是土匪啊，都是替天行道，对对，然后还弄一个牌子替天行道这样的，然后就带了一大堆人拿那个替天行道就去抢劫了。OK, now I think,Okay, this is also very interesting, the Japanese, and very short. The Japanese God is called the Sunlight God, 日照大神。哪里？日照大神。Japan, in their original pronunciation is Nippon. 日本这两个字念成 Nippon. But why they don't call their country Nippon anymore? Because they were defeated in the Second World War. And Nippon is a very proud, term for them. So instead, they are not going to call them Nippon anymore. They call them Japan. Which is, an English word, you know, rather than a Japanese or kanji, you know, 因为它跟汉字没有什么关系。日本那个真正他写日本，但是他的那个这个日文发音是 Nippon, 那后来呢都不念 Nippon 了，因为战败了就念 Nihon, 这样的。那 Hon 也可以啊， Hon, 你要轰打那个 Hon 是本嘛，哎，所以念 Nihon 就不会想到二次大战战败，然后念你蹦，那时候他们最强，然后最骄傲的时候就念你蹦，这样的，哎，这你当然要懂日文，然后读日本文学才会知道，跟日本历史。好，我呢妥图了一些啊，几十本是有的啦。在哪里？好 ，So Japan, Nippon is the origin of sun. 所以日本是日太阳之本啊。然后，So the Japanese god, is a sun god, who is also a creator. And now, it's very interesting to note.By the way, the Japanese emperor, 天皇 Tenno, meaning heavenly emperor, is much higher than the heaven's sun. 这个日本天皇啊， 称为天皇，但是他比天子还要高，你知道高多了。为什么呢？
According to their mythology or the creeds of their native religion, Shindokyo, the heaven is the emperor's elder brother, while the sun is the emperor's younger brother.
Okay, 在哪里？ Okay, so the highest is the emperor, the heaven.
So he is the big brother. And the Japanese emperor is the second brother. He is the younger brother of the big brother heaven. And the sun is the emperor's little brother.
所以他是老三，所以上天是老大，天皇是老二，太阳是老三，这样。所以那
So as a result, the Japanese emperor would become the uncle of Chinese emperor.
所以这个日本天皇就变成中国皇帝的 uncle 了。为什么？中国皇帝是天子，是天之子嘛，而日本天皇是天的弟弟嘛，所以他就变成他的叔叔了，你知道吗？叔叔或是伯伯这样的，好，应该是叔叔哈。
Japanese emperor, but nowadays it seems that no one would believe the deification anymore.
但是现在没有人会相信这个帝王神格化，说他是神的，不管是儿子也好，或是弟弟也好啊，就不会没有人会相信这个了，对不对啊？
Even the Japanese who are noted for their piety and obedience have often called their emperor Tenjang instead of Tenno-sama.
甚至于啊，最虔敬的、最服从的这日本人啊，那么现在常常也都叫他们的天皇叫Tenjang啊。那尊敬的法尊敬的词是说，如果请叫一个人叫Tenjang啊，赏，比如说哦赏、令赏。
It's the medium respectful,
or okay,
but for higher or superior people, you would call him sama, or o sama, lin sama, or Peter sama. But if we are just brother and brother, I'll call you Peter san.
Okay,
so it's different. But if you are inferior to me, then or my small brother, little brother, then I call you Peter Jiang.
Okay.
So, and the Peter Jiang would be like, because you call Ten Sang or Ten Sang, and Peter Jiang would be like the diminutive form in English, like Tenny.
知道吧？哎，所以小天呐，天你就变小天了。本来是天皇，下面说小天啊，或是小天天这样。
Okay, so which shows that, the Japanese people, do not believe in that he is really, the brother of heaven.
Okay.Because they are blaming him for the defeat in the Second World War.
Well, it's not totally his fault, but of course he is responsible. Therefore, in modern times, the old gimmick of deification andThe like mythical things are not going to work anymore. through various revolutions in the past, in all spheres in our life or their life, religious, philosophical, political, social, etc. And the technological also. People have already outgrown their mythical past. All that is left is but a flimsy vestige which has found it harder and harder to hold its losing ground.
所以啊，在现代的时代啊，这些老旧的玩意儿啊，这 gimmick 啊，就神格化的 gimmick 啊，已经不再有什么作用了啊。那因为经过了，在过去经过了各方面的种种的革命，像宗教革命、哲学革命、产业革命、政治革命、社会革命等等，所以人们呢、啊、已经 outgrown 就超过了、超出了这一些这神话的过去，而所剩下的只有一些微弱残余的遗迹啊。那这些遗迹啊，就被发现了，这越来越难守住它渐渐失去的地盘。
OK, maybe this is all, but I have a lot to talk about later, but Indians and Jewish and everything. And OK, let us show them this very quickly. OK, in the Old Testament, it says that the Jewish God is the creator of the whole universe, but it only mentions the earth, the sun, and the moon, only three heavenly bodies. But you know, there are nine planets in this solar system. Okay, and so what about Mercury, 水星, Venus, 金星, Earth, 地球, Mars, 火星, Jupiter, 木星, Saturn, 土星, Uranus, 天王星, Neptune, 海王星, Pluto, 冥王星, and all these. And only three planets were mentioned, and the others was not nominated. 翻到下面一页是，还上面一页。Okay, so the whole universe, what is the whole universe according to modern astronomy? The universe constitutes solar systems, 太阳系, and galaxy, Milky Way, 银河。为什么称为银河？因为有几亿、几十亿、几百亿的星星啊、哦，星球啊，然后这形成一个带状，那好像一条河一样，在空中看起来好像一条河，所以称为银河。不是真正有一个河啦啊，而是那个星星太多，然后集在一起，像一条河一样，所以称为银河。然后比较科学的称法就是 galaxy, 就是银河。Gala is Greek, meaning milk.So they are the same. In one galaxy, there are billions of solar systems, as astronomy tells us. And then in a bigger system is the insular cosmos.
In one insular cosmos, there are billions of galaxies.
所以在一个岛宇宙里面呢，有几百亿几千亿的这个银河。
然后 And then nebula or nebulae. In one nebula, the singular is nebula. There are billions and billions of insular cosmoses.
所以在一个星云里面呢，就有无数无量的几千万亿的岛宇宙。
And in the whole universe, there are billions and billions of nebulae. So, the universe is infinite.
这宇宙是无量的，无限的。
So, and the Buddha also says, disciples asked Buddha, how huge, how big is the universe? And Buddha says, there are 3,000 megathousand cosmoses.
有三千大千世界。
And this is only one Buddhaic cosmos. And how many Buddhaic cosmoses in the whole universe? And the Buddha said, infinite, innumerable.
所以有多少佛世界呢？有多少三千大千世界呢？无量无数。
So the Buddha knew 2,500 years ago that the universe is infinite. And he says in all the sutras about the 3,000 megathousand universes.
所以佛在佛经里面都常常在提三千大千世界，乃至于提到这么我们听了中国人即使不学佛都知道大千世界，对不对？那怎么来的？
佛经里面来的。
大千世界就是讲这个世界是无量无边啊。
So I think it is not correct for the Jews or the Jewish God to proclaim thatHe was the creator of the universe. For the whole universe is far wider than the ancient Jews could ever imagine. An astronomer said, John C. Duncan said, the solar system, vast though it is, forms but a speck in theUniverse of stars and nebulae.
So the Buddha also knew it.
And besides, there are some fallacies, or majorly four fallacies, in the account of creation, in the Genesis.And the Bible.
这个在基督教圣经里面关于这个神造宇宙啊有四个大的错误。
First, the earth as the center of the universe. And of course we now know it is not correct.
所以说地球是这个宇宙的中心。这是错误的，对不对？
Second, the sun and moon are created for the earth.
啊，这太阳跟月亮是上帝为地球人造的。为什么要造？为什么要造？太阳跟月亮呢？
Why did he create sun and moon? Because he wanted human beings to have light.24 hours in the day, the sun would give off light. In the night, the moon will do that for us. So, the purpose of sun and moon is for the earth, and rather is for human beings. So human beings are great. And third, so yeah, the sun rotates around the earth. And for the disproof of this, Copernicus in the 15th century or 16th was burned on the stake for his heresy. 这个圣经里面讲说地球绕着太阳绕着地球啊，这是错的。那这个因为证明了这个是错的，所以哥白尼啊用天文望远镜望见呢，就证明了是错了，所以因此他就被放在十字架上烧死，因为他提倡邪说。Fourth, the earth is flat. 说圣经上说这地球是平的啊， and everybody believed it until in the 14th century, the Portuguese Da Gama sailed around the world and proved it is wrong. So I gather this is due to the primitive rudimentary knowledge of the ancient Jews that created this limited, narrow-minded, and self-centered view of the whole universe, which was then attributed to their God. 因此我想啊，这是由于这个原始的这个古犹太人啊，他们这个原始的而且很初级的对于这个这个宇宙的了解啊，所以就创造出了这样子的这个狭隘的啊，以及自我中心，对于这个宇宙的自我中心的这种观点，然后他们把这种狭隘的观点呢，就赋予他们的神啊，说是他们神说的啊。Besides being of primordial ignorance, it also shows self-conceitedness of a race for self-assertion and preservation. 啊，这个，所以除了无知以外啊，这古代人的无知啊，那而且还表现了这个自大啊，一个种族的自大啊，夜郎自大了啊。但是这个不是没有原因的。But this, to see this in the light of comparative religion, it is actually quite normal and popular in world history. Such as the Chinese have always called their country the middle country, which means that it is in the center of the whole world. 但是由比较宗教来看呢，这种夜郎自大的这种说法呢，在这个世界史上也是很平常的，很通行的。就像我们中国人啊，就把我们的国家称为中国啊。这中国的意思你没想过？中国就是说我们这个国家是在这个整个地球的中间。我们现在知道不是嘛，可是我们已经叫惯了，所以就还是叫中国嘛，对。The ancient Indians also did the same. 这古代的印度人呢，也是把他们的国家称为这个中国。你如果看佛经里面，他讲到中国这两个字的时候，不是讲我们华夏民族这个中国，是他们印度民族那个地方称为中国，你知道吗？所以不要搞不清楚了。Even the Japanese view the country as the origin of the sun. 那日本呢，也甚至于日本呢，也把他们的国家当作是日出之始，日的本源啊的国家。And the Europeans, the ancient Europeans, call their sea The only sea they knew, the Mediterranean Sea, which means that this sea is in the middle of the earth. Okay, Mediterranean, mid, M-I-D. 有没有？这里有没有写出来？啊 ，M-I-D is middle. Terranean, terra is the earth, the middle of the earth. So this sea is in the middle of the earth. So this is a self-conceited, arrogant view of the European countries. You know, their sea is in the middle of the earth, which obviously is not correct. So it is quite popular. So I would say all the ancient religio-political hyperbolic self-conceitedness was done not just for pompousness, but was done deliberately for two aims: survival and expansion, if possible. 所以啊，这古代的总而言之，古代的这个宗教政治的夸大之词啊，那自我夸大之词啊，不是为了要充算，你知道吧？不是要假装，而是故意的有两种目的：第一个就是 survival， 要活下去；第二个呢，就是要扩展。所以能够活下去以后就要扩展了所以 survival and then expansion. Both of these feasible and justifiable. To make both of these feasible and justifiable, so they make the hyperbolic pompousness. 因为要令他们的这个活下去、存活以及扩张可行以及可以说得通行之有理所以创造了这一些自我膨胀的这种说法对他们自己的国家Because we are the greatest race in the world, so we need stick together for our survival.因为我们是世界上最伟大的民族，所以我们应该团结在一起，我们才能活下去。And also because we are the greatest, so it is our responsibility in God's will or the heavenly will to lead the whole world. 因为我们是最棒的民族所以领导全世界是我们的责任这是神的意志或是天意如此 And that's all for today. There are more. Boy. I am not near half done. One-third.Only. Next is philosophical Taoism. It's very interesting too, I guarantee, with no additional charge. Would you like to hear more later? I mean, not today. I know, you are tired. Me too. Besides, you don't need to use energy by sitting there and only concentrating in hearing. But who would know if you were concentrated or not, or you are dozing? Okay. Thank you very much for your attention, and Buddha bless you all. for your wisdom. 呃
Thank you, thank you, thank you.